When the crazy blonde kid on TikTok starts to convince you that the earth is flat.
In Stanley Kubrick's 2001 A Space Odyssey, made in 1968, the crew didn't have the luxury of modern-day digital visual effects.
They had to rely on miniatures and practical effects, like this floating pen. It was attached to plexiglass with a piece of double-stick tape. I had to try it myself, and it was not easy getting rid of the reflections, but I'm sure in a controlled environment it'd be a lot easier. When it came time for the actor to grab it, she just pulled it off the plexiglass, like this.
Basically, they attached one corner of the plexiglass, and it acted as a big pendulum.
I can't imagine the pressure the effects department was under. Stanley Kubrick was a known perfectionist, but I'm sure they understood the gravity of the situation.
Yeah, I see a lot of people on here that they make fun of people who believe the earth is flat, and they do it with such an arrogance. It's like they know for a fact, like they've been to space and they've looked down on the earth. You know, they know what they were taught. And it's funny because you go to school and you literally learn, well, I mean, you learn how to read and write, but you don't learn how to learn. You learn how to fucking memorize and regurgitate. And they basically train you to get in your little box, stay in your box, and don't get outside your box. And that just sticks with a lot of people. And they can't see anything outside their little box. You know, I've always said the day you think you know everything is the day you stop learning. So I've never put much thought into the earth being flat or round. But to be honest, after watching a lot of these videos on here, I can honestly say I don't know. I'm leaning toward it being flat, to be honest. You know, with all the evidence I've seen, it's pretty crazy. But yeah, if people make a claim, I mean, unless it's so outrageous and stupid, but I'm just saying, like, we know the government lies to us, and we know that they've lied to us about almost everything. I mean, just look at Brandon. He got more votes than any president in U.S. history. I mean, they tell you this shit, and yet you'll believe everything else they say. So, just keep an open mind, guys. All right.
If your flight had to make a sudden emergency landing and landed over 1,000 miles away in 3 to 4 states away from anywhere you're supposed to be, would you question why? Let's talk about it. So a flight from New York to Hawaii had a pregnant woman on board who went into labor, and they had to make an emergency landing immediately. Where did they land, you ask? Seattle, Washington. Now, upon looking at that flight pattern, it goes about the top left corner of New Mexico is about the closest you could be to Seattle, either somewhere in there or Arizona. Now, hypothetically, let's just say they were the closest they could have been to Seattle in order to make this make any type of sense. So pretty much anywhere between northeast Arizona and northwest New Mexico, Albuquerque area. Now, if I had somebody going into labor, would I risk a 3-hour detour from Albuquerque to Seattle? Just rough numbers. They were somewhere around Albuquerque. Gotta be for this to make sense, you know what I'm saying? Because Seattle was close, right? Seattle is nowhere near the flight path that they should have been taking to Hawaii. Unless you happen to have a flat earth map somewhere handy. Oh, now it's making a lot more sense. Would you looky there? That's crazy. Now I see why they would stop in Seattle. Yeah, I know what you're thinking. This is just one occurrence, right? One flight doesn't mean anything. How about the emergency landing that happened on a flight between Dallas and Beijing where they landed in Calgary? That doesn't make much sense, does it? Oh, shit. That does make sense. What do you know? Okay, two flights. That don't mean nothing. What about the flight from London to Pakistan where they made an emergency landing in Moscow? Why would you risk flying over all that land and all them countries in the event of an emergency? Oh, okay, it wasn't risky at all. It's actually right. Okay. No, that makes total sense as to why they would land in Moscow. Or what about the flight from Chicago to Doha, or however you pronounce it? They also had an emergency landing in Moscow. Odd. Oh, okay, not so odd now. Not so odd now. That makes perfect sense. I can see that. Not even just emergency landings. What about Auckland to Peru? Why would you go all the way up here to Los Angeles and then down to Peru? Why couldn't you just go across? It's the same amount of ocean almost. I mean, pretty close. Oh, okay, because Los Angeles is in a direct line almost of Peru and Auckland. Man, that's crazy. Wake up, guys. They're lying to you. The earth is flat, guys. It's time to wake up. Take back your freedom. Peace and love.
You guys want to hear something interesting? In every neighboring continent country next to Antarctica on the flat earth model, including South America, New Zealand, Australia, Madagascar, Africa, every single one of them that border Antarctica, the cold place, they all have penguins there. All of them. There's penguins there. There's penguins there. There's penguins there. There's penguins there. And there's penguins there. It's because it goes all the way around Antarctica. And they swim from Antarctica to these places. There's a reason why there's not penguins in Florida. There's a reason there's not penguins in India.
This shit made me second guess reality.
Okay, but let me see it.
This video is of, you know when Elon sent a Tesla into space?
Yeah.
So he sent a Tesla into space and there was like a dummy in it. But look.
Let me see.
So this guy was watching it live stream because this was a live stream, right?
Okay.
Look what happened.
Yo, look. Look how fake this is. Look. It's Elon Musk.
So he's watching the Tesla live stream.
Okay.
Boom. You see that?
Pause it. Look. Where, yeah.
So pause it. Okay. You see the Tesla and the robot. Look where it is.
Where is it?
It's.
Is
that, look. Like, now keep screen? Watching. Keep watching.
Okay.
Space. What is this? Oh wait. Let me fix it. Let me unpause this. Look at this.
Oh. No. All of a sudden, in space. In space.
How they do that?
That shit was fake the whole time. That shit was fake the whole time. They faked the Tesla being in space, bro.
So I was cleaning off some bookshelves in my house, and I want to show you guys what this one book in particular says about the shape of the earth. Here's what it says about the firmament. You guys can pause it and read it if you want. And it even has a little image of what the flat earth would actually look like.
I really need an explanation real quick. You can never be too careful. Just watch this real quick. Now, as we all know, they like to put messages in movies and TV shows. I don't know if y'all seen this, but in the movie Gods of Egypt, it was a scene of space and what Earth looked like from space, and it was flat. Even in Thor, they show Asgard to be a flat plate. Now, it is sad, a lot of people say that we live in a dome. Y'all remember this woman? Look at what she finna say.
And I can't believe we just put the biggest crack in that glass ceiling yet.
Now, we all know the Simpsons be putting in hidden messages and everything. Now, look at this part. Now, some people say Jesus is holding everything together. But in school, do y'all remember when they taught us about gravity? And they had said the earth was round? So I had asked my teacher, if it's round, why don't people fall off the bottom of the earth? And you know how water falls down the stream? Gravity don't stop it, it just goes down. Wouldn't the earth look like this? Cause like, how are you holding all the water in place? It says, gravity is most accurately described by the general theory of relativity proposed by Albert Einstein. Again, the Newtonian theory of gravity is based on assumed forces. If gravity is a theory, can Earth really be a globe? Or does it look something like this? I know you're probably like, is the water gonna fall off the edge? Some people say we're surrounded by ice. You know, like in Game of Thrones, even in Teen Titans too. It just makes me question, that's all I'm saying. Kinda just makes me feel some type of way because they're showing it and everything. Now it is what it is if it's flat or round. But when I heard her talk about it, I was just like, Y'all be safe.
What is the firmament and why are so many people talking about it? On my recent video, I talked about the lake under the ocean and so many people commented about the firmament, so I did some research. The firmament is a belief by many different religions that the earth is actually a dome and that there's water above and below us. that separate us from the heavens. Look how many religions believe this. Even the Freemasons on the bottom right. Supposedly the people who run the world, maybe. God said, and I quote, "Let there be a firmament in the midst of the waters, and let it divide the waters from the waters." Let it divide waters from the waters, huh? Sounds kind of familiar. There's also some interesting pictures of Elon Musk's rocket creating ripples in the sky. So there's ripples in the sky, there's ripples under the ocean. What if they're trying to break through the firmament? Who knows? What do you guys think?
The sad thing about the world is nobody wants to hear the truth. There's a small community of truthers that I have tapped into that talk about the truth of the earth, the truth of the world that we live in, and the truth of who rules this world. Ever since the fallen angels, including Satan, who were kicked here from heaven to earth, they have been ruling through governments, principalities, and powers, and no one's talking about it except a small amount of people. And it's not the church. You're not going to learn about truth in church. As a matter of fact, when God called me to separate myself from the church, that's when he started revealing truth to me. So if you're like me and you're desperate to know the true things of God, the deep things of God, then separate yourself and get in his word, and only then will you find the truth. I used to think that going to church 3 times a week and being a good citizen is what Christianity was mostly about. Until one day God called me out of the church because I knew there was something more. Since I studied my Bible every day, I started to realize that the firmament was something more than what I'd always thought it was. It is the dome over our heads, or in other words, the blue sky that we see. The more I dug and the more I searched, the Lord revealed his truth to me. Space is not real. It's not what they have told us. There is water above the firmament and below the earth. Now, this is according to what the Bible teaches. Of course, NASA and man, aka the enemy, who has taught us and indoctrinated us since birth, has taught us. So you have to ask yourself a question. You can either believe what we have all been taught by the enemy, because he's the god of this world, or we can trust what the Bible teaches. I want to encourage you to think for yourself. Use your own brain and study God's word, and don't listen to what the narrative is saying. Because I promise you, there is more out there to what has been taught. God is real, and one day the sky is going to roll back and every eye is going to see him. Now, I don't have time in this short little video to tell you everything that I want to, but I want you to do a little experiment, because I know it's hard to accept that the earth may be different than what we've always been taught that it was. I want you to get a drone, and if this is something that you really want to know and you really want to prove to yourself, then hover it above the ground for as long as the batteries will allow you. And if the earth is spinning at 1,000 miles an hour, like they tell us, which is laughable, then the earth should spin underneath that drone, but it doesn't. This is just one little experiment that you can do. There are hundreds, and people have proven flat earth, and that is real science. All the things that we have been taught is scientism. It's fake. There's no proof of what they're telling us. We have got to lose the indoctrination and use our own minds.
Flat Earth, yep.
Flat Earth,
yep.
Flat Earth,
yep. I'd like to welcome y'all to Flat Earth,
yep.
Flat Earth,
yep.
Flat Earth,
yep.
I'd like to welcome y'all to Flat Earth. They say the sun 90 million miles away. I can't tell, I've been around.